We are going to start learning about exponents. Now, this may be something you've seen in the past, but you may not have really used them. So we're going to start making sure we understand what is an exponent and what do they do. So first, we need to know that there is the base. This is the number that's the factor. It's the number that we're going to repeat over and over. So if we have 4 times 4 times 4 times 4, that equals 4 to the third. And 4 is the base. This is the number that we repeat over and over, right? The base is kind of like what something sits on. It's the main part of it. We're using the number 4 over and over, excuse me, and over again. Then we also have the exponent. This is the number that tells us how many times to multiply that factor. And we need to make sure we are multiplying. We're not adding. We are not skip counting. We are multiplying. Oh, that shouldn't say, I'm sorry, that shouldn't say it's the base. That should say, I forgot to change that. 3 is the exponent. So if we have that same problem, 4 times 4 times 4, 4 to the third, 3 is the exponent number. It said to use the 4, the base, 3 times. Another word you might hear that called is 4 to the third power. Power is just another word for exponent. So let's try some of these out. So if we have 5 to the fourth, we're going to write that out in expanded form. So the base is 5, and we're going to multiply that 5 or 4 times. Whoa! Lost my power here. So 5 to the fourth, 5, 4 times. The base is 5, we multiplied it 4 times. Now, the thing I see students do is they go 5, 10, 15, 20. Nope, that's adding. That is 5 times 4. We are multiplying, so we're going to connect here. 5 times 5 is 25. So I'm expecting to see your bridge connection here. And then I have 25 times 5 again. 25, 50, 75, 100, 125. So these should get big really fast because we're multiplying over and over and over, and we're not adding on. So now we have 125 times 5. So 125, we have times that by 5. So here's 25, 10, 11, 12. 5 and 1 is 6. So this ends up being 625. So these little numbers can get big really fast. So 5 times 5 times 5 times 5. There is 625. We are going to have a few more examples. So if you need to write over here as well, that's great. Okay, this time we're going to go backwards. We have 3 5 times. So this is 3 to the fifth. And now we need to solve it out. So we have 3. The base is 3. That's the number that's repeated. It happened 5 times as the exponent. We are not skip counting 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. That's adding. We are multiplying. 3 times 3 is 9. 9 times 3 is 27. 27 times 3 is 81. And 81 times 3, we're going to throw in a problem really quick, is 3 and 24. My final answer, I don't have any more factors. We have 243. So it got big really fast. We are not skip counting. We are multiplying it bigger and bigger. All right, this is the most commonly missed one. Everybody loves to look at this and they're like, six, I know that one. Nope, we're still going to write it out. I know it's simple, but we're going to do it because it's going to take us a really short amount of time, and we're just going to do it to get it right. So we have 2 is the base, and it happened 3 times. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. 2 to the third is 8. It is not 6. It's not 2, 4, 6. We're not adding. We are multiplying. So I'm expecting to see this when you do your work. All right, then we have 1 half is the base, and that happened 4 times. So 1 half times 1 half, 1 more times 1 half. So 1 half 4 times. Now, sometimes we're like, oh, fractions. Nope, we just do the same thing. Numerator times numerator is 1. 1 times 1 is 1. 1 times 1 is 1. Our numerator is 1. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. 8 times 2 is 16. That was it. 1/16. So we took half and we cut that in half, and then half of that and half of that again. So when we do fractions, our numbers like should be getting smaller because we're cutting them into pieces. So expanded form, write it out. How many times did it happen? What's the base? What's the exponent? How many times did that happen? So what we need to know is that these are repeated multiplication. We are not adding, and it has to be a number that's repeated. So right, this is multiplied, but it's not repeated. That's a bad example. It's not an exponent. 3, it is multiplied by 3. So it was repeated, the factor. So this would be 3 squared, right? 3 to the second power, light bulbs power. And this is repeated, 3 and 3, but it is added. That is not an example of an exponent. So exponents have to be repeated factors, and it has to be multiplied, not added. So let's try out a few and see which ones are the same. So when they are the same, they're going to have the same value. It's going to have the same base, and it's going to have the same exponent. So this happened, 8 is our base, and it happened 3 times, 8 to the third. 8 times 3 is 24. That is not the same. This is 8 times 8 is already 64. And then we do 64 times 8 again, not the same. This one, 8 to the third, we have 8 times 8 times 8. This one, we would have 3 8 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the ones that are the same, 8 to the third and 8 times 8 times 8, these are the same thing. They both have 8 as the base. It happened 3 times. So this one, we have just multiplication. 6 times 4 is 24. 6 to the 4th, 6 is the base, and it happened 4 times. This one has 4 as the base, and it happened 6 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can see these are not the same. That has a base of 6. That has a base of 4. Not the same. This has 6 as the base, and it happened 4 times. So 6 times 6 times 6 times 6 times 6 times 6 and 6 to the 4th are the same thing. Here we have 3 is our base, and it happened 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. 5 to the 3rd has a base of 5, and it happened 3 times. These are opposites of each other. Here we have repeated, but it's adding. This is not an exponent. This is not 3 to the 5th. These are not the same. This is 3 plus 3 is 6, plus 3 is 9. Plus 3 is 12, plus 3 is 15. This is really like doing 3 times 5 is 15. Not the same. None of those are the same so far. So let's see which one this one matches. The base is 3, and it happened 5 times. 3 to the 5th, 3 to the 5th, 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 times 3, and 3 to the 5th are the same thing. So we've got to watch, is the base the same? Is the exponent the same to make those matches? Okay, go ahead and write yourself a note about exponents and bases. That is going to help you remember something in the future.